Welcome to Informed Sources on News Channel 3, where we discuss the big stories with local voices. I'm your host tonight, Stephanie Scurlock. Thanks for joining us. In a moment, I'll introduce our panel, but first tonight, we have a lot to cover, so let's get right to our topics. The hot topic this week, we'll discuss the repercussions of a letter sent by Shelby County leaders to Attorney General Jeff Sessions asking to end federal oversight of the Shelby County Juvenile Court that's been in place since 2012 when they discovered discrimination and a failure to provide required due process to juveniles in lockup. Taking our questions tonight and agreeing to be on the hot seat is Shelby County Mayor Mark Luttrell. Also this week, the U.S. Department of Justice announced it has chosen Memphis to be one of 12 cities to receive federal assistance in beating drugs, guns, and gang violence. And tonight, we're also reaching into the mailbag. That's a new segment where viewers like you pick the topic. This week's question is about big money's influence in Congress and what it says about our country that candidates will spend millions to fight for a job that pays less than $200,000. And now to introduce our esteemed panel. Sitting on the far end there is Otis Sanford, WRET political commentator. And in the middle is commercial appeal columnist Tanya Weathersby. Thank you for joining us. And of course, sitting next to me is Shelby County Commissioner Steve Baser.
Thank you.
All right. Well, on the hot seat tonight is Shelby County Mayor Mark Luttrell. And Mayor, first of all, you sent this letter along with the sheriff and also Dan Michaels, the judge of juvenile court, to Jeff Sessions. Tell me, why did you send the letter?
When the Attorney General was in town a month ago, there was a group of us that had breakfast with him one morning, and included several of the people that have been so closely involved in some of the criminal justice issues in our community. We referenced the memorandum of agreement that we had with the Department of Justice, and we asked him to take a look at it and see if we were in compliance enough that we could be released from the technical parts of the wording of the agreement, and he said, send it forward and it'll review it. So we drafted a letter. It was signed by the three elected officials that have had primary jurisdiction of this area, and we have not received any response at this point. He made no assurances one way or the other. I would add, Stephanie, that this is not an unusual occurrence. I've been through this before when I was the sheriff and we were under a consent decree there, and we made one appeal during the process, a six-year process, and it was denied. And then we made a second appeal later on and it was accepted. So it's not unusual to ask for those reviews. In this particular case, a new attorney general, a new set of leadership in the Department of Justice. And we thought it was good from two standpoints. First of all, for him to become familiar with some of the issues that we're facing here in Shelby County, and to see if we are in compliance to the point that we can be trusted to carry through with the obligations that we've made.
Well, this is creating quite the controversy in the community. I want to play something for you now. The NAACP political action chair and the chairman of the Shelby County Commission immediately came out against this and have promised to send letters of their own to the Attorney General asking for that oversight to continue. Let's take a listen to that.
Right now, our juvenile system is getting an F. We are asking through methods of cronyism for that F to be acceptable. We don't, as a body, the NAACP does not believe that that F is okay. Our kids deserve an A.
All right, our kids deserve an A. Questions for the mayor, starting with you, Otis.
Well, I think my biggest question, and again, I can't make an assessment about whether the juvenile court should no longer be monitored or not. I guess my question for you, Mayor, is there seems to be some discontent because people didn't know that you were doing this, especially the county commissioners, other stakeholders in the community, and especially when you look at the fact that it was one county commissioner who was no longer on the commission, Henry Brooks, who sort of helped to start this thing a long time ago. Why did you not feel the need to bring others in to the plan to ask for the Justice Department not to monitor?
You know, Otis, this is a situation that we've been working with for some 5 years. We've had monitors that have come in periodically to do assessments. We have a court monitor that works very closely with DOJ. We've never had an expression of interest on the part of the county commission on this subject until this past weekend. And it was a little bit of political theater that we had in the county commission meeting on Monday. And quite frankly, I wish I could see that same level of passion every day. And to see a passion when the telephone is not ringing and not when the newspaper is reporting on it, but a passion for what's right for our children in this community. So we're going to continue to do the best that we can to remedy the situation. I think we've made some significant progress. There's still much work to be done. Even if we were released from the memorandum of agreement, there would still be obligations that we would have going forward. I think we have an opportunity with that letter that we presented to really appeal to let local people solve local problems. It's what we did with the jail. I think we were successful in that regard. I think most people would agree that we were successful.
Well, let me ask a very brief follow-up, though, very briefly. If it was political theater by some members of the commission, do you think it was political theater by others, the NAACP and other people in the community who are concerned about this? And if you want to have the community solve the problem, again, why weren't they consulted before you did this?
They have access to everything that we have access to, and they have had for 5 years.
Okay.
The documents are online. What surprised me the other day at the county commission meeting is how few people even knew who the monitor was. That's the person that's a county employee that takes care of those reports, who reviews those reports. Never once has he been invited to address the county commission on the issues at juvenile court.
Well, Mayor,
I want to see the community as engaged as those of us that have been dealing with this every day have been. And that's my challenge to the community, to the NAACP. We would welcome their engagement. But don't just come when it becomes a political issue.
Okay. Tanya, I want to ask you to kind of weigh in here. Do you understand why those people feel left out of the process? Oh. And should they have been a part of the process?
Yes, they should have been a part of the process. And actually, the reason why a lot of those people feel left out is because a key part of the problem with the juvenile system, and what a lot of people have referenced, and what one of the monitors referenced, is that African-American youths, this community is predominantly African-American, still continue to receive a disproportionate punishments as relates to the crime as opposed to white youths. One of the monitors said that. I wrote about it in my column. Mm-hmm. His name escapes me. He did all the statistical work on that. That's a huge problem, just the unequal carriage of justice. And I spoke with the mayor earlier this week, and he said, well, that's something that the judge and the juvenile system has to handle. But when you talk to average people about that, what they see is that the mayor is the mayor, and the mayor can do a lot of things, including bringing people to the table, no matter what system they're in, to deal with this. So a lot of people feel left out because a very, very key part of what's going on with juveniles, has not been really addressed yet, and they don't know what's going to happen going forward, and that really upsets a lot of people.
I think we're missing some of the keys, though. The county does have a lot with the juvenile courts. There has been a process in place, and part of that memorandum of understanding is that process exists. And I wish if the mayor could speak on that a little bit, but there are groups that meet all the time that look at the juvenile courts. There are groups that
you're
meet.
On the, you're on the county commission?
I'm on the county commission.
Right,
and
have you met with this group?
Mm-hmm. Well, I've met with the Department of Justice folks when mm-hmm. they've come a couple of times. So mm-hmm. I've been following up on some of the things that the findings in terms of the disproportionate contact and whatnot. Mm-hmm. I think we're making gains there. Now, we're not going to get there overnight, but we are making progress, and I think that's what's missing in the discussion. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of people who took this initiative to jump up and be outraged. Well, I don't agree with the NAACP that we're getting enough. We made a lot of strides. The sheriff now is in control of the detention center, and that's made huge improvements. We're looking at doing a juvenile assessment center to help stop the flood of youth from, into the juvenile court system.
Yep.
And we're looking at probably in the next year or so, making an investment in the detention center itself and reconfiguring the juvenile court. So we're about to make some sizable investments in that. I think what the mayor is asking for really is just to say, look, we've done a lot, and we don't necessarily, it costs us money as a county to have those people come and interview people and give us a rating. And so I think we're looking for a little bit of relief on that. And it's not saying we're taking our foot off the gas pedal. Mm-hmm. I do agree with some folks, though, that, in the spirit of collaboration, perhaps more people should have been in the loop, so to speak, on what we were asking for as a county. But, you know, it's hard to do that all the time. And, you know, I mean, even in my job, you miss out on a few people, and people get upset, and that's okay. That's part of the process.
So, Mayor, at the point we are now, is there going to be an effort to bring the community in or to even ask them? I mean, you're the mayor, so you have the authority and the voice to do that.
Yeah, Stephanie, I think we have a real, real chance here to embrace this as a community. It's interesting when you hear some of the people criticizing the move that we've made are also very critical of the current Attorney General in the Department of Justice. Mm-hmm. And I would like to give us an opportunity at the local level to solve this problem. And
but some people also feel that you use this opportunity with the Attorney General, you know, being Republican.
Well, of course we did.
He's
the new Attorney General. But what I'm saying is that the people that have vilified the Attorney General are now vilifying us for trying to take it away from the Attorney General and deal with it locally with the local elected officials that they select. So we've got three locally elected officials.
More political theater, maybe.
Maybe a little bit, but the sheriff, the juvenile judge, and the mayor all elected locally. And what we're saying is give us the responsibility of fixing our problem. Mm-hmm. We don't fix it. That's what the ballot box is all about. Mm-hmm. And I would like to think that if you're not strongly for Jeff Sessions, then give Mark Luttrell a chance.
All right. We've got so much on this topic. And
Real quickly, Tanya. What you all described, the strides you made and the biggest problem, the disproportionate sentencing, but a lot of the mistrust in the community is, okay, if you made all these strides, why are you asking to come from under the oversight right now? And once you're from once the oversight, will you continue to do that? I mean, will that just be a license for you to stop doing what you're doing?
That's what the county commission is in place for, is to monitor our moves and to hold us accountable, which they haven't done for 5 years. So I would challenge the county commission
as a commissioner, I have taken an active interest in that.
All right.
And I will say that not all commissioners have taken an equal interest, mm-hmm. but I have met with those people from the Department of Justice. I have met with the Judge Michael a number of times. You know, very encouraged by what I've seen happening there.
Well, let's get the public involved, because involved.
A little bit more transparency here, and I think we'll be good.
All right. Thank you, Mayor, for
being
on the hot seat tonight.
Yeah. not, not,